Good morning. My name's Ken Sayer, Design Manager at the Advanced Design Studio in Irvine. Let me, always seems designers are cleaning up engineers' messes. I don't know what's up with that. Anyway, let me adjust the stage a little bit here. Well, so far, Tetsu's given you a good description of the content of the Mazda 5, the buyer for the Mazda 5, and Stan's done a great job explaining what goes on underneath the sheet metal. My presentation is going to cover basically what you see here, the exterior styling, the concept of Nagare, how we introduce Nagare on this car, and also some of the, I would say, unique challenges we had in bringing such a unique design to production. Nagare, this car is based on the Nagare series of concept cars we did. The term Nagare, for those who don't know, directly translate in Japanese to the word flow, and it basically represents the movement and the flow found in nature. I think some of these images are good descriptions of, you know, the movement of water when wind passes over it, or the shapes that sand takes when wind affects it. Also, even you can see the shapes that a sail would make, or a piece of fabric when wind blows through it. These are all very natural shapes in nature, and our goal was to capture that in this vehicle, in the sheet metal, and in the styling, as well as on the interior. We felt the Mazda 5, while it might not seem as a minivan, it would be a perfect place to try something as avant-garde as this. We really felt that the Mazda 5 was a perfect opportunity to introduce this styling. What we found with consumer groups and focus groups with Mazda 5 customers was that they're really not the typical minivan buyer. They're really looking for something that's unique, something that's got personality, some styling that sets them apart from the typical minivan. And that's why they gravitate to the Mazda 5. This is not the kind of vehicle that Toyota and Hondas make, as Tetsu mentioned. This styling is very unique and very out there, and it's a real stretch in this category of vehicle. Nagare styling, well, you see it on this vehicle. This is what we call a complete, what we want to look at is more fully adopted Nagare styling. Some previous vehicles, you might not be aware, like the Mazda Speed 3, we introduced some elements in Nagare styling on that, on the front grille, and on the Mazda 6, you can see some influence in Nagare styling in the headlights and the taillights. But this is the first fully, if you will, fully adopted Nagare design in our lineup. So, moving on, what I'd like to do is talk, excuse me, let me go back, I'm sorry. The other point I wanted to make is, obviously, from a styling standpoint, Nagare it's very dramatic, it's very expressive. But in the development of the car, what we found was not only was it an aesthetic dynamic, but we also found it had a lot of functional elements as well. And by introducing Nagare styling, we were able to manage the airflow over the vehicle. As Stan mentioned earlier, by managing the airflow over the front of the vehicle and the side of the vehicle, by the attitude of the A-pillars and the way air moves around, we were able to reduce wind noise. And as well, we were able to adjust the airflow over the hood with some detailing in here to keep the, generally this is a very high pressure area and there's a lot of wind noise around the windshield wipers, and some of the detailing we did in the hood, and you can probably see better when you see the cars outside, help reduce the wind noise and control airflow over the vehicle. So what I'd like to do now is, that's a little brief history on Nagare, but I'd like to go into the basic design development process we go through in every car, but specifically for this vehicle. The design process starts with sketches. In this case, we had a lot of different ideas going forward. We really wanted to express the emotion and the innovation in the design. From that stage, scale models are produced. We had models from all our global studios in California, in Frankfurt, Germany, and in Japan. And at this stage, one theme is selected. This theme was selected because it had the most potential from, again, being exotic, the proportions were good, it was an emotional design, and it offered us a really good palette to introduce some more Nagare texture and Nagare styling. At that stage, from that scale model, it goes back into 2D and there's some more design refinement takes place. You can see in these images, there's a little more design detail being done in the front grille and capturing that Mazda 5-point grille, getting the right balance and evolving it from the previous generation of products. From that stage, a final sketch is developed. In this case, this was kind of the final theme sketch, or the final sketch that was shown to senior management and approved to go forward. Now, you know, I've been in the designing cars for over 15 years, and looking at that sketch, that's a concept car sketch to me. That's not a production car sketch. I think it says a lot about Mazda and our management team at Mazda, that when you look at a sketch like that, the management said thumbs up and let's go forward with it. I think you probably guys would agree there's a lot of cars you see on the road and you wonder, how did the management guys ever hit their thumbs up and say, let's build that thing? But you look at that and that's a concept car sketch. What's even more impressive, I think, is not just the dynamics of the sketch, but how close the final car you see sitting up here is to that sketch up on the wall. I mean, that's again, only unique to Mazda. I think Mazda is one of the few companies that has, if you will, the balls to go out and do that and to make a car that has that kind of dramatic styling in essentially what's a people mover vehicle. So from that sketch, we develop a full-size clay model. At this stage, you can see this is very close to the final production model. There's a few small change, small differences you can see in the front end, and these are really influenced more by wind tunnel testing than aesthetics. A lot of what we did in the front corner to clean up the airflow around the vehicle, and as well in the rear to clean up the airflow under the vehicle, so it's got a little bit cleaner wake behind the vehicle and the rear bumper. So during this whole development process, as we were getting the basic proportions and the balance of the vehicle, what we call getting the mass control, we were also looking at this Nagare texture and the best way to represent it on this vehicle. Now, as a van, as a taller vehicle in proportion to its width, we're obviously looking at some way to make the vehicle look slightly lower and a little bit more stable. And you can see in these examples, we tried a few different iterations of this texture. We obviously wanted it to be dramatic enough. We didn't want it to be too much where it just scared people off, but we wanted it to be strong enough that it had made a real statement, it had real character to it. And you can see in the final image, this is very close to the final design texture and the vinyl feeling that we went with in the vehicle. One thing you notice in most of these sketches for the scale models and the full-size models, we do them in silver. That's the typical way of presenting models. It tends to show off the surface best. But at this stage, our color and trim group asked, well, this is great. It all looks really good on this silver car, but when we start introducing black and red and white on this vehicle, how are these colors going to look on this kind of texture and this kind of form? So we undertook a research stage, which was unlike anything we'd ever done at Mazda. And very early in the development, we actually worked with stamping engineers, which we had never done before. Usually they come into the program when you have final design sign off and the final design is basically goes to production. But we had them in this early stage stamp test panels for us. And then what we did is we painted them various colors. As you can see on the right, on the left, we looked at more what we call metallic colors, more lighter colors that have more gradation. So what you're really representing, like for example here, is more light highlights and shadows. You're not getting the real strong reflections. On the right, you can see we're looking at more high contrast colors and how they would play against the surface. Overall, our goal was to really make this dramatic, but also make it really high quality with a real precision look. We didn't want it looking like it was made of plastic. Those top two images you see there are interesting because during this process of developing the car, there was a group that felt like we could do this better if we did it in the computer. Obviously, the computer seems more exacting and you can have tighter tolerances and you can look at the reflections with programs in the computer. And then there was another group that felt, no, this is the way we've always designed cars. We do it by hand. We have craftsmen. We have skilled modelers with tools that do this by hand. The idea is this is a vehicle you want to run your hand along. It's based on nature. It's basically supposed to be done by hand. And so at this point, the two groups decided we're going to try one direction of each. And the top two panels you see there were done in the computer. Now, from my perspective, when you look at the red image, the high contrast one, it looks like it's almost made of plastic. And when looked at that with our management group, they realized, yeah, this isn't the look we're trying to capture in this. We really want a very high precision feel. So at that stage, the decision was made to continue developing like we always develop our cars. All our Mazda products are very sensual, beautiful forms, the kind of forms you want to run your hand over. And that's how this was developed, the old-fashioned way, if you will. And you can see how the different colors are represented here. You'll see all the colors outside today, and you obviously get a better representation looking at them outside. But we did put a lot of time and effort into making sure that the vehicle looks great in every color. Another thing, obviously, it being a minivan, as Tetsu mentioned, you park in tight spaces. You're at parking lots. You have family, regardless of the fact you have a sliding door, not everybody else has a sliding door. So it's natural to expect at some point this is going to get dented or scratched. And you guys probably looking at this probably think, yeah, this looks great, but how difficult is it to repair? Well, Mazda engineers thought the same thing, and through the development of this, they also looked at how easy it would be to repair the vehicle. And in their test, they found that essentially it was no more difficult to repair this than the previous model, and therefore they were very confident that developing this wasn't going to incur any additional cost to the consumer. One other additional note, we had an experience just last week as we were getting the cars ready for the presentation here, and we did end up getting a dent in one of the vehicles right in this area out of all the places to get it. So perfect, you know, form follows function, if you will. We called in a paintless dent removal guy, not knowing how long it was going to take him to do it. And I think it was between 15 and 20 minutes, Stan, he came in and he massaged the surface and he took the dent out. And again, so just proving the point that just because it's really dramatic and there's a lot of movement and a lot of form on the sheet metal, it's not any more difficult to repair if you do get into a situation where it gets dented or scratched. So now I've given you a little background on the design of this vehicle and also a little bit of the Nagare. I'd like to go into a little bit more of our just overall design philosophy at Mazda and what we call our Mazda DNA. This Isaac's Mazda 5, basically every vehicle we build has some basic fundamental lines and proportions that we build in every vehicle, whether it's a Mazda 2, an RX-8, or a Mazda 5. And we start with what we try to get a really dynamic silhouette. You can see a really strong silhouette and then also a very strong front fender line. This is very characteristic of just about of every Mazda on the road, a very strong shoulder line, a driving shoulder line from the rear of the vehicle that moves to the front. It gives the vehicle a lot of movement. In this case, we introduced another element with this Nagare texture to bring even more flow and stretch the vehicle out even more. These images as well, you can see the same basic fundamentals. And again, if you look at this, you can almost envision a Mazda 2 with the basic, the same characteristics and the same design lines, just slightly different proportions. And in front view as well, we put a lot of emphasis and spent a lot of time in really massaging and evolving the five-point grille and getting the right balance between the size of the grille in relation to the lamps. We want to keep the grille below the headlamps to give the vehicle a kind of a visual balance and a stability. And by keeping the grille below the headlamps, it also helps visually lower the vehicle. In the rear, we wanted to get a nice, wide, stable stance. This vehicle, for a vehicle with sliding doors, has the most prominent rear fenders of any minivan on the market, if you will. We adopted the horizontal taillights in the rear, essentially to give the vehicle a much more wide and stable stance. Now, as I mentioned, this, the DNA, again, you can see this in every one of our products. When you look at a Mazda 5, you can see all of these key character lines. And the current products on the road as well. But even going forward, for those of you who have seen our Shinari concept car, fundamentally it has the basic same design elements and the same key lines as on the Mazda 5. Again, a strong grille, strong front fender line, and a strong line driving from the front to the back, and a very sensual surface, very nice soft forms, very dramatic design. So that gives you some idea. Looking going forward, as you see this Mazda 5 and you see Nagare, Nagare will continue to be evolved. You'll see it, more elements of Shinari as we go forward. But the basic fundamental building blocks, if you will, or the foundation of every Mazda will continue on in the next generation of products. So that covers the exterior of the vehicle. I'd like to touch a little bit on the interior of the vehicle as well. We had the same design directive, if you will, the same objectives was to get as much flow and movement in the interior as we possibly could. Obviously, it's a big vehicle. We wanted to get a lot of flow and movement from the instrument panel through the seats and through the doors to the back of the vehicle. You can see here the basic movement of the vehicle. We wanted to get a more of driver-oriented cockpit. The movement of the vehicle, the cockpit, starts from the top of the gauge cluster, surrounds the driver. The openness on the passenger side, we wanted to basically have each feel like they're in a compartment, but when you get in the car, you'll see it doesn't feel cramped at all. It feels very purposeful. The driver compartment, everything is within easy reach, and it feels like you're in a driving-oriented vehicle, but it still has a lot of space. It doesn't feel tight and confined. We put a lot of focus, Stan touched on a little bit, on listening to the customers of the previous vehicle and improving the areas that need to be improved. We've obviously raised the information display higher so that you don't have to take your eyes off the road when you're driving. It's easy to see for the driver. We improved the air vents, the air conditioning vents in the center. We've raised them up, not just for front seat passenger comfort, but also helps airflow to the rear of the vehicle. The previous ones were lower down, and the rear of the vehicle didn't cool as well as it should have. We've increased the size of the blowers for the air conditioner. We've also, again, listening to consumer comments, we added more storage space on the instrument panel, more small storage for small items, you know, keys, iPods, etc. We paid special attention to the seats as well. We obviously wanted to bring flow into the seats and get that dynamics that you see in the exterior. You wanted to get into the interior. One way we did that is when you see there's no lateral seams in the seats, all the lines flow from front to back. We also, to increase comfort, we widened the seat back. Stan touched on a little bit some of the engineering innovations, but from a design standpoint, we made the seat backs and seat cushions wider for the front seat passengers. And also, for the mid-seat passengers, we considered, you know, adult seating, as Tetsu mentioned. Kids like to jump in the back, and we found more adults sit in the middle seats than we originally thought. We thought that would be more for kids. And so to answer to that, we've made the seat cushion slightly longer, and also the cushion thickness or more dense for adult seating. So again, we've looked at a lot of things in the previous vehicle. We've improved upon, we've listened to the customers' comments and their suggestions, and we brought them into the design of this vehicle. Along with that, we've also raised the quality of the interior. I think when you guys get in it, it's a little maybe hard to explain in a picture, but when you get in it, you'll see the quality of this interior is amazing. I mean, the feels of the switches, they're all intuitively placed, the location of the HVAC system, the layout of the radio knobs and the audio knobs. Also, we've added illumination to the gauges so that during the day, if ambient light hits the gauges, you can still read the display, the information display. And again, we laid out the audio system to be more intuitive, not just during the day, but we found at night, when you get in a vehicle and you put the lights on, you're just seeing a bunch of lights. It's very hard to really know where you're going to work the radio. So a lot of attention was paid to designing it so that it's actually intuitive and precise and that you can actually operate it at night. So all of these things, including the improvement of materials, we added chrome plating and trim to some of the areas you touch most that get the most wear, door handles, radio controls, audio controls, steering wheel controls, and we've just, overall interior quality is improved. And again, this is something you take some time when you're in the car to feel around, feel the instrument panel, the textures, the door panel textures, and just the overall improvement in quality in the interior.